Here's the progress update, peoples. As you can see in front of the camera, we have got the readout display for the Sangamo HM meter, and it is currently not inside the meter. Okay, so let's pick up the camera and let's have a look around.
What's that big black lump?
Well, as you can see, there's a load wheel inside it. Okay, there it is. There's the load wheel. I think that's the marker there. Yep, that's the marker. But as you can see, that's not in there either. Okay, let's pick up some of these lumps and have a look at them. Okay. There we go. Oh, so that's quite heavy actually. There we go. And that is basically what Sangamo done with a lot of their instruments. You had like a split chassis design. Okay, now that technique is very similar to what's inside, like say for example the S200.7. you release three screws and then the front of the instrument just comes off, and then all the electromagnetics is left inside the casing, and that would be say similar to an S200.31 or an S309.7 or maybe even the big S301.1, where you've got a split chassis design. You've got the mechanics in the front half, and then you've got the electromagnetics in the back half, and the two just split away from each other. Okay, now I cannot set that down because as you can see that load wheel sticks out of the back, and if I was to set it down like that and it was to fall over, it would dent the wheel. So I'll have to be very, very careful when I set that down that it stays upright like that. And it does sit there quite happily. You see, I can push that. Okay, I can wobble it. And it stays there quite happily. It's quite rigid there, so it's not going to fall anywhere. Okay. But as you can see by the size of that, those accuracy magnets are just huge. Okay, they are held in place with those two screws there and that large, particularly thick retainer plate. Okay, this is solid British engineering, as you can see. Okay, no cheap plastic rubbish here. And that's all of the prepayment mechanism. You've got your pence, which is denoted by letter D. That's the old pence, the pre-decimal pence. Shillings there, and your pounds there. And that's how much credit is left on there. Okay, and I've had a look at this mechanism, and I don't think the tariff is somehow settable. But look at this little box here. It's got those gear wheels inside it, and you'll notice it's stamped on there, it says 3D. Okay, which, if I'm correct, means 3 pence. In which case, if that is, then that means that this meter is set up for 3 pence per kilowatt hour. Okay, I mean, these days it's more or less like 12 pence per kilowatt hour, so unfortunately, I don't think the tariff on this is settable. You may actually have to remove those screws, take that out, and then put in a different ratioed gearbox or something in order to reset the tariff to a different charge. Okay, that may very well be why I've never seen one of these instruments before, because once the cost of electricity exceeded that,
the meter then had to be removed and have a different gearbox put inside it, and the electricity board just weren't going to bother doing that. And therefore, they just removed and junked a lot of these. Now, up there, there's a little square box, and it says on there 2D, 2 pence, but someone scribbled it out and then put a number 3 up there. So that somehow says to me that this meter was set on 2 pence per unit before this new gearbox got put in there. Okay. So I've got a feeling that to change your tariff on this, you've got to screw a different ratioed gearbox into that so that it runs it down at a faster speed or whatever. So yes, I've got a feeling that is why a lot of these instruments no longer exist, because the electricity board was not going to bother taking these instruments out, screwing different gearboxes into them and then reinstalling them. Okay, now the later Smith meters, you could actually set the tariff manually. You could actually have the coin mechanism out, you take the coin mechanism out, you just turn it around to a different position and then put it back in, and thus the tariff was set. But on this, it's precision engineered into the workings. There's only one way of changing it, and that's to manufacture basically a different ratioed gearbox. And I wouldn't mind betting that was particularly expensive. Now, let's have a look at this readout again. There we go, there's the readout. Now, there's something about this. It's all metal, no cheap plastic rubbish. Okay. And there's a stamp on the back of there, there's a rubber stamp on the back of there. And it's a bit difficult to make it out, but it says on there, you might be able to see that actually, it's 1, and there's a big old space, and it says 4, 5, 6. Now I'm wondering if that means maybe April 1956. It could very well be. But yeah, that's the readout. It is 0820.1.10. Okay. And the instrument number is obviously 664-7422. Now, after having all of this out of the case, okay, there's a pile of nuts there, and we are in so far by 20 minutes. By the time I've figured out how to get all this out and then tackle which bit to remove first, and then having everything out of the case, well, all of this anyway, there's that little button around the side of the instrument which you press the coin reject. That just fell out. I know where that goes anyway. But by the time I figured out how to have all this out and which bit to remove first, that bit came out first, that bit came out second, and that bit came out last. And of course all the pile of nuts and bolts and screws and washers and things. Now, after having all of that out, I was only left with this part. Okay, that's the electromagnetics. There's the current coils down the bottom there. Okay, there's the terminals there, and that goes across the switch. There's a switch there, and it comes back to the other one. And the only thing holding this in place now is these electrical connections. 1, 2, 3, 4, and that little one there. Now, I am so tempted just to remove that. It'd be silly not to leave it in there. You know, all I've got to do is just undo those electrical connections and whip that out. So, I just might go for the whole hog, just to have everything out of that case and clean it up. As you can see, it's pretty marked and dirty around the exits hole, where the coin goes out into the coin box. And it's pretty mucky and dirty around that one as well. So, I just might as well have the whole lot out, people. But yeah, there's the voltage coil there, and there's the current coils there. So there it is. Come back a little bit later, peoples, and we'll take it from there. Catch you later.